good evening. I forgive that. Good evening.
Good evening.
Welcome to Springfield Assembly of God. We're glad that you're with us tonight for our 2018 Christmas Cantata, presented by Praise and Worship and the drama team from here at Springfield Assembly. Without further ado, for those who may not know me, I'm Pastor Ridwell Luther, that lead pastor here. And without further ado, I'd like to introduce our praise and music pastor, wherever he is. There he comes, coming up here, Pastor Josh.
Good evening, everyone. Hallelujah. See, God surprised me. Praise God. Well, I believe His sweet presence is in this place. And so we just want to encourage you this evening to worship with us. Yes, we hope that you enjoy what we come up with, but more importantly, we just want God to be glorified. You know, when Pastor Rick and Pastor Melissa came here in July, it's been 6 months, hard to believe, they asked us in a leadership dinner, actually meeting rather, about what do you think the purpose of worship is? And you know, we truly had never really been asked that. And so we had never truly, in one accord, discussed what it meant. And we all got together and we truly just believe that our purpose is to usher in the presence of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Where two or three are gathered in His name,
yeah,
He is in our midst.
Amen. Amen.
So tonight, I've asked a gentleman, my brother in Christ, Mr. Adam Woodard, if he would portray Jesus as a visual representation of His presence tonight. So in the center of our sanctuary is a throne. We can't imagine what His throne is going to be like, but we are tonight, in our human form, we are going to allow Christ to enter in. So as we worship, we're worshiping our King. Amen? This is not just for fun. This is just not for, you know, entertainment. This is real tonight. How many of you believe that Jesus Christ is real?
Amen.
And He's alive tonight, amen? And if you're here tonight, amen, amen. If you are here tonight and you're going through something, maybe you're smiling, we're praying for you during our time of prayer this evening, that if there is something going in your life, God knows your circumstance, He knows your need, and all you have to do is to trust Him completely in your situation, amen? Whatever it is, you might think, well, my situation's not as bad as so-and-so's. He cares about your need.
Yes,
if it's health tonight,
amen,
He wants to heal you, amen?
Amen.
If it's your mind tonight that's been tampered by the enemy, He wants to touch and renew you tonight,
amen.
Amen? If you've just been discouraged by whatever, amen? He tonight wants to encourage your heart. Amen. So our prayer this evening is, Lord, be glorified. Lord, take our burdens this evening and do with it as we know you can do. And that is transform them into your goodness and your grace. Amen. Hallelujah. Would you bow your heads with me this evening? Father God, we thank you. First and foremost, Father God, we thank you for your sweet, awesome presence. And tonight, Father God, you are indeed our honored guest. And we pray tonight that as we sing these choruses, these hymns, Father God, these carols, that you, Father God, would be glorified. We want to thank you, Father, for your Son, who you allowed to leave heaven, to come to this sinful world, to teach us to be a symbol of your love, and then to die upon a cross that he didn't deserve. But because of that death, that perfect sacrifice, we as Christians have that blessed hope of eternal life tonight. So Lord God, we give you glory in all things. Because even if things aren't great in our lives, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that the blessing is we have life eternal with you this evening. So Father, we thank you, we praise you tonight, and we bless you in our songs. Have your way. Holy Spirit, continue to penetrate hearts this evening, we pray. And we will not fail to give you praise, honor, and glory. And every child of God said, amen, amen, amen. Glory. May you be blessed tonight.
Jesus. Yeah.
the song that you sang asked the question, is there room in your heart? At this time of year, a lot of things fill our hearts. Love for our families, love for the season, love for shopping, love for baking Christmas cookies, love for eating those Christmas cookies, love for being together, love for singing songs. There's a lot of things that fill our hearts. And even we who know Jesus, at times our hearts become full of busyness. You know, years after Jesus' birth, when he was in his second year of ministry, he was sitting in Mary and Martha and Lazarus' house one day. One sister is in the kitchen busy making dinner. The other sister is sitting at his feet. Jesus, tell my sisters to come and help me. And he said, she's chosen the greater thing. The greater thing. Now, is there anything wrong with making Jesus dinner? No. Because I know if Jesus showed up at my house, if Jesus showed up at your house, we'd make him something to eat. I've started to call him first. But we want to serve him. We want to do those things. Well, likewise, we can become busy. And this time of year is no different. And out of that busyness, an emptiness can set in. And sometimes, without realizing,
we forget
what this season is really all about. That the trees and the gifts and the candles and the singing and all, that's really about him and his coming. And the fact that he came willing to lay down his life that you and I could have life. And have it abundantly. You may be here tonight thinking, you know what, there's only 8 days to Christmas, but I've got gifts to buy, I have pies to bake, I have cookies to make, and the family is coming. And all those things are good because I love Christmas. Those who know me well know I love Christmas. Love it. Not just in December. I'm one who listens to Christmas music all year long. Yeah, I'm the guy that you hate. But as good as those things are, let me be honest with you, I have to slow down at times. Because we can be so caught up in getting ready for plays and programs and practices and shopping and decorating and all of those things, preparations for family to come. And we get busy like Martha in the kitchen and we forget to be Mary at his feet. So I circle back and ask you the question that these gentlemen just sang, is there room in your heart for him? All of us have to ask that question. Because in this time of year especially, we can become so busy. Our hearts get full of good things, but not necessarily God things. So again, I ask, is there room in your heart for him? Is there room? The last line of that chorus says,
God to write his name.
his story.
For God to write his story.
See, ultimately it's not about the story that I want to write or that you want to write. It's about what he wants to write in our lives. See, the Word of God says in the 139th Psalm that before you and I were even born, God wrote down all the days of our life in his book. He saw you and me when we were still in our mother's womb, when we were still in our mother's belly, being formed. He saw you. He knew you. He proposed a destiny for your life. And the things that happen in our life have brought us to this point here tonight. You're not here by chance, not here by happenstance, not here by circumstance. You may think that you are here by an invitation. But even that invitation was God ordained for such a time as this, for all of us to pause and take a moment and ask ourselves the question, is there room in my heart? Is there room in my heart? And sometimes we'll say, yes, there is. But I want to paraphrase that song, if I can, for just a moment. And ask you this question. Is the room that you have given him the room that he wants? Is the room you have given him the room that he wants? Just because we carve out a small space in our life and we think, okay, I carved this out for Jesus, but the rest is all of mine. See, that's not what God wants in all of our lives, any of our lives. He wants all of our heart. He wants everything that we have. You know, in the Christmas story, the wise men came from afar away. And they came. They bowed down at baby Jesus. And they began to open the gifts that they brought. Gold and frankincense and myrrh. Costly. Very costly. But when they opened it up, they didn't say, okay, Jesus, here's a little for you, and I'm going to keep the rest. They gave it all. And that's what God asks us to do. To open our heart. Not just a small space, but open it all. And make room for him. In a moment we're going to pray. And if you have never asked Jesus into your life, we're going to give you an opportunity to do that. Maybe you have asked Jesus into your life and your life has gotten full and your life has gotten busy and your priorities have gotten out of whack. That's okay, it happens to all of us at times. Now's the time, tonight's the time to realign, to rededicate, to fully open our heart and turn it over to God. Amen. And here's how we're going to do this. In just a moment, I'm going to ask you to bow your head. And I'm going to lead us in a prayer. And I'm going to ask all of you, all of us, to say it, for to repeat after me. And if you're here tonight and you've never asked Jesus into your life, I want you to just say this prayer along as we pray. If you want to open your heart some more, if things have covered it over you, you asked Jesus into your life months ago, weeks ago, years ago, decades ago, but life has happened, become busy and out of sorts, join us in this prayer. Rededicate your life to him. Can you bow your head? And simply repeat these words after me. Jesus,
I admit I've fallen short. Things haven't always turned out the way I have planned. And Lord, I know that without you, I cannot make it. Jesus, I ask you to forgive me. Forgive me of my sin. Forgive me of my shortcomings. Forgive me of the times that I have failed you.
Forgive me of the times that I failed you.
Forgive me for taking over my heart.
Forgive me for taking over my heart.
For not making room for you.
For not making room for you.
Jesus, come now.
Jesus, come now.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
Take me.
Take me.
And use me.
And use me.
God, I give you my heart.
God, I give you my heart.
Not just a part of it.
Not just a part of it.
But all of it.
But all of it.
As the wise men laid their gift at your feet.
As the wise men laid their gift at your feet.
I give you my life.
I give you my life.
Take it and use it for your glory.
Take it and use it for your glory.
Jesus, thank you.
Jesus, thank you.
For dying on the cross for me.
For dying on the cross for me.
I give you praise.
I give you praise.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
For saving me.
Amen.
Amen. Here's what I want to ask you to do. I'm not going to ask you to come forward. Here's what I am going to ask you to do. If you prayed that prayer for the first time tonight, or that rededication, life has just kind of gotten out of whack, and you want to make a step in the right direction. Sometime after the program is done, I want you to just come to me or come to Pastor Josh and just tell us, I prayed that prayer tonight. All right? We're going to shake your hand, we're going to hug you, we're going to do that, you know. We're going to put a gift in your hand, something that's just going to help you along your journey to get started, just kind of help you, give you some things to read. Nothing big, nothing fancy. But come and let somebody know that you made that choice today. Pastor Josh, come on up here. You guys ready? All right. As they're coming, I want to encourage you, if you do not have a church home, stop by and see us. We would love to have you. If you do have a church home, I want you to go where you're going. All right? And be there Sunday morning, because your pastor's looking for you. All right. God bless you. Thank you.
lifted our midst, amen. We've lifted our hearts, we've lifted our songs unto Him, and I'm certain He's pleased, amen. Thank you, Father God, for your sweet presence. Let's bow our heads, Father God, Lord. Again, we consider this an honor tonight, Father God, to extend our heart, to extend our praise, our worship unto you, Lord Jesus. We ask now, Father God, through the remainder of the season, Lord Jesus, that you would remind us daily from moment to moment, it isn't about the hustle bustle, it isn't about the perfect gift, but it is about you. And you are, Father God, the perfect, extraordinary gift, Father. May we extend you, your love, your grace, your perfection, Father God, to others, Lord Jesus. Father, equip us with your Holy Spirit as we go forth this season and we just live, breathe, smile, hope, Father God, and be your hands extended, Lord Jesus. Bless our words that they might be your words. Bless our hands that we might use them to please you, Jesus. And Father God, tonight I ask that you remove all self, Lord Jesus, in all things. That, Lord God, you would fully reign as we surrender tonight, Lord God. Bless each one here tonight. Bless those that are listening, whatever way, Father God. But, Lord God, may we leave this place feeling and knowing you are with us always. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. We love you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. And we give you glory. And all God's children say, amen, amen. Love someone tonight. Give them a big squeeze, not a 2-second squeeze.